Welkom terug hier bij Expresso. Nou, binnenkort skop een awesome competitie af voor de Expresso Marinade Master 2013 competitie waar ons die beste marinade in die land soek, want ons is so lekker braaikultuur hier in Suid-Afrika. En ek gaan vir julle vertel hoe julle kan inskryf in 'n paar minute. But first, we are going to be showing how to make the ultimate marinade, and we have the ultimate braai master contestants with us, Carl and Carl and Greg. There we go. Friday morning. How are you doing, buddy?
Well, you're right.
Yeah. So listen, you guys, you made this recipe, this marinade, and this is what I like about being South African, is because we are able to do these things. We come up with creative ways in making our meat. So tell me a bit about the recipe you're going to be doing.
Well, I mean, the recipe is actually the first marinade I ever learned, and it's one of the first marinades. It was from my old man, and one of the first marinades that I think most South Africans learn.
Yeah.
Which is kind of, you know, your tomato sauce, chutney, Worcester sauce, garlic herbs, and Coca-Cola.
All right.
You know, but now today what we're going to do is we gave it a bit of a ginger twist and a contemporary twist. So apricot jam instead of peach chutney, soy sauce instead of Worcester sauce, ginger, garlic, cayenne pepper, all the liquor stuff. And then ginger beer instead of Coca-Cola.
All the liquor stuff. I like it. Of course, you can make this marinade yourself. You can just SMS the keyword marinade to 33728. We'll send you on the Pick n Pay shopping list. All right, gents, time to get started. Where are we going to go?
Okay, we're going to start off with the marinade. This is quite warm. So it's the beauty about marinades is, you know, you can be, you don't have to be as precise as other things. So, you know, we're going to start off with a bit of tomato sauce, about 100 mils.
All right, so you say you don't need to be as precise. But yeah, I mean, I'm sure you need to have it kind of
fair. Yeah,
right,
I mean,
you guys are trained, you know how much to go in there.
For this one, we normally just do equal amounts of tomato sauce and equal amounts of jam.
All right.
Let's just get this going. And the reason you, the reason you heat it up is because you want to get, all the sugars and all that breaking down.
All right, and now the famous ginger beer.
The ginger beer from Ginger Day.
Kiss Ginger Day. Are you sporting a bit of ginger there? I said no.
Well, you know, my ginger's at home. I kiss a ginger every day.
Oh, do you?
She's 3 years old.
Oh, cute, man. That's awesome.
I know she's watching Dad on TV today.
You must give her lots of kisses today.
Ah, for sure.
Oh, sweet, man.
Cool. So as this starts to break down, we can start adding in ginger.
Nice. Some more actual ginger, right?
Ginger, yeah. A little garlic.
Perfect.
You know, the cool thing with marinade is you've got to, you know, with any marinade that you're starting from scratch, and you've got to just ask yourself kind of two questions, you know. What protein are you going to be using, and what do you want the marinade to do?
Okay, so explain that a little bit more.
Well, like today, you know, we're going to get something that's more of a basting sauce, so it's sweet, sticky, lots of sugar.
Okay.
Works really well with like chicken on the bone, and something like spare ribs or something like that you can par cook a bit. Very fatty meats or whatever, and you want that kind of sweet stickiness. Also, the ginger comes out. Something else that works really well with is chuck. Very underrated piece of meat.
Really?
Chuck's that quick on the braai, you get that kind of sweet stickiness, it's awesome. And then marinades also, you know, you've got to ask, what is it going to do? You know, do you want it to tenderize the meat? Do you want it to, for flavor? Do you want it to cook it a bit? Like if you're doing tuna, you can put tuna in a bit of lemon juice and soy sauce, and it actually cooks it a little bit beforehand.
Wow.
So there's a thing behind
it. Science behind marinade,
Science, I think, is a strong word.
Well, come on, you know, look at what you guys do. So this specific marinade, is this something you would leave the meat in to marinate, or is it something you brush over while you're brine?
You know, if you're doing meat, like I say, we've got chicken drums and thighs here, and we've got spare ribs. And what you'd want to do, you can put it in before, but then if you've got to pre-cook this meat a bit so you get heat to the bone.
Yes.
So you can wrap it in a bit of foil, do it on a slow fire for a little while, get the heat to the bone, and then take it out, let it rest for 10 minutes so all that like flavor goes back in, and then just baste it, like the last 40% of cooking and stuff, and then you hit it hot fire, you know, just blacken it up on the corners, all good.
Awesome. Okay, so where are we in terms of the recipe?
Cool, so now we've put in the lemon juice and the soy sauce. You can see how much darker it's gone.
Yeah.
And then we're gonna add in, it's about a teaspoon of paprika.
Lovely.
You know, paprika's nice, it always gives it a nice red color,
a nice flavor.
Smoky flavor. Yeah. And then we've got our cayenne pepper, which is always good. There you can put as much as you like.
A little bit of a fight right there, but of course you can get all the ingredients sent to your phone by SMSing the keyword marinade to 33728. The Pick n Pay shopping list will be delivered with you in 2 seconds. All right.
Cool.
Perfect, so a little bit more apricot jam.
A little bit more apricot
and that's
jam.
Pretty much it.
You know, it's all up to you. It's up to personal taste.
However
you, and that's the nice thing is you can taste it as you go and you can add.
Oh, and that smells lovely.
A little bit of pepper.
Cool.
There is a lot of there is a lot of sugar in this one, so you got to just be careful. Yeah, when, like Greg was saying, you want to just put in to towards the end of the cooking. You know, you don't want to burn awesome. Everything on there.
Nice. Great. So that's it, and then you just go ahead and brush it over your meat as we go.
Yeah.
No. Cool. Greg, cool, Carl, thanks a lot, cool. man. This is awesome stuff.
Thank you very much.
You carry on there. Cool, yeah. Now, as I mentioned, we are launching an amazing competition where we are looking for the ultimate marinade maker, the Espresso Marinade Master of 2013. All you need to do is submit your marinade recipes to recipes@expressoshow.com. You can enter as many times as you like with as many different recipes as you like. You will be crowned as the Espresso Marinade Master. You will come on the show and make your marinade, and you will walk away with a fantastic braai hamper. Get emailing right now. Graham, over to the car review.
Ooh, supporting businessmen like Sibusiso Tshabalala and his Berry Hill Trading Company, that's where we found goodness. Pick and Pay, always there for you.